Hey guys, so as promised, today I'm going to do my sort of review of the Emily Edit palette by Makeup Revolution collaboration with Emily Noel 83. If you don't know who Emily Noel 83 is, where have you been living? She's probably one of the most down-to-earth and yet one of the original YouTubers. I remember watching her videos and she was still using a crappy camera with really bad lighting in her closet, I think, or with her closet as the background. Anyway, I'm so happy that she has actually come out with her own eyeshadow because I've seen her reviews and she's one of the people that I trust the most when it comes to reviews. Her point on like packaging, on quality of the products, on how it applies, longevity and all that. So whenever I am curious about a certain palette, I would go ahead and watch a video of hers if she's reviewed them. And yeah, one of the influencers that actually influenced me, I think she's got another one that's called the Needs palette, which is a combination of face and eye makeup, but I didn't think I needed that, even though it's called the Needs palette. But I definitely wanted the Wants palette. Now let's talk about this particular palette. I'm gonna be honest, the packaging is not my cup of tea. It's very simple. It's peachy hard plastic with rose gold writing and Emily's signature on it. Nothing wrong with it, it's just not my aesthetic. It comes with a huge ass mirror, as you can see. There is everything. Yeah, it's got a huge mirror. It's the same size as the lid. So there is no problem in doing your makeup with this particular mirror there. I like that it stands on its own. I remember Leisha from X Parkage always talks about palettes not being able to stand on their own. Like, for example, a lot of Urban Decay palettes are like that, that you kind of have to hold them up, otherwise it flip-flops over. Now this one, it stands on its own. And in case you haven't seen it yet, and I don't know why you wouldn't have, but these are the colors in the palette. How beautiful are they? I'm gonna be honest, when I first saw this, I was like, oh, it's nice, yeah, sure. And then I realized it was Emily Noel's collaboration with Makeup Revolution, so I was like, I'm in. And the great thing is, this cost me $22 Australian. I know in the US this is $20, and you can pick it up at Ulta or at the Revolution Pro or Revolution Beauty. I don't even know what they call their website anymore. It used to be Makeup Revolution, then it became Tam Beauty, and then now it's something else. Anyway, you can pick it up online, but it's also available in Ulta in the US. Unfortunately, here in Australia, it's only available through their website, but don't fret because the shipping is quite cheap. I think I paid like $2.75 Australian to get this shipped to me, and it came 10 days, I think, in 10 days. So that's not bad for something that needs to be shipped all the way down under. That's pretty good. Now, I've watched Emily's story and the making of this palette and what each of these shades mean and how they are part of her life. So these are very, very beautiful. I have used most of them, if not all of them, but I don't know if I have to do a swatch fest for you guys, because let's be honest, everyone on YouTube has already swatched this palette because it's all over YouTube. I'm just gonna swatch it on me so that you can see what it's like on my color, and I'll do it on here. Fine. I wasn't planning on a live swatch. Okay. Ooh. So these are the top shades. That's the cream. You can barely see Hobby there because it's almost the same shade as my skin. Prayer, Grateful, Good Vibes, and Side Hustle. It's like cool, right? Here you start with Midwest, Juice Paid, Eve Rose, Bell Violet, Capricorn, and Pyphy. I think it's what it's called, Pifee. That's her sorority, I think, when she was in college. All right, so that there is Oh Heavens, Love Tons. Oh Heavens is dedicated to her mom. Love Tons is dedicated to Tyler. Obviously, earlier Eve Rose and Belle Violet are for her children. Pizzazz is apparently her favorite word in the English dictionary. Family, Top Story is a throwback to her broadcasting days. And Apartment, which is where she started filming her videos about almost 10 years ago, if not already 10 years ago. Okay, last row. Okay, so the last row you've got Cupcake, which is their cat. Laugh, Cry, Cheer, from when she was a cheerleader. Heartbeat, Corduroy, this green right here. This is my favorite shade. And then Dark and Early isn't quite black, but it also isn't quite charcoal gray. So it's hard to describe that, but it's a beautiful shade to help deepen your eyeshadow. Now that I've done that live swatching with you guys, I'm gonna cut into me applying the makeup that I have right now. And so I started out with the color Love Tons on either side of my eyes, inner corner and outer corner. And then to blend those two, or to connect those two, I had Cheer placed on there. And then that sort of golden, beautiful shade that you are seeing is actually Grateful, which is green gold, I would say. And it just goes beautifully against that reddish shade. And then I added a little bit of Family onto the crease area just above where I placed Cheer. So it's sort of like transitions. And then the cream is the brow bone highlight that I used. So that is the eye look that I had. I've been playing around with this for a while, and I find that some of the shimmer shades can give you a little bit of fallout, so just be careful with that. But if you're the type who does your eyeshadows before your foundation, then you should be all right. I have kept it a point, or I've made it a point to actually use the eyeshadows first before I do my makeup, because it can be a little bit powdery. I don't know if anyone else has ever said that about these, because while I've seen a lot of reviews, I haven't actually watched a lot of them. These shades, I've always liked the formula of Makeup Revolution. Some of them can be a bit of a dud, but most of the time you get really good really good product, and this is not an exception. This is really good. The mattes are really pigmented, they really pop, and the shades transfer in the same color as they are in the pan, so it's not deceptive, if you know what I mean. The shimmers are beautiful, they've got a lot of impact. Now, some of, like Top Story, for instance, is a little bit more glittery, like the shimmers are a little bit bigger. I normally try to use that as a foiled shadow using my Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray to foil it, and then it really, really shines. So very, very beautiful. I am very happy with this. You get 20 I can't even count. It's 24 shades in here. So 6 times 4 is 24, right? Yeah. I don't particularly go for large palettes anymore, but I'm happy with 24 shades here. And they're not shades that are like so small. They're the same size as MAC eyeshadows. I'll show you. Okay. This is my MAC Warm Neutrals palette. And then this is the Emily palette. And as you can see, the pan size is the same. So you really get your money's worth on this. And I love the different colors. She's incorporated warms and cools, because that's always what I see in her videos, is that she's always talking about how some things are missing, or like it's too warm or it's too cool. This is a good mixture of everything. You've got a highlighter, you've got a it's not really a black, a dark shade that's really great for darkening your eyeshadow or putting like emphasis on it. And then every color in between is beautiful. The metallics or the shimmers are buttery. The mattes can be a little bit powdery depending on which one you're using, but they are really, really good and very, very pigmented. Overall, I love this palette, which is the reason why I actually ordered another one to put in a giveaway for you guys. I'm just waiting for it to arrive. I did do an order with Makeup Revolution again, so stay tuned because that's definitely coming your way. Meanwhile, thank you very much for watching this review. Let me know if you did get any of the Emily palettes, like you got the wants or the needs or you got both, and let me know what you think about them. Really, this was something that I bought because I really wanted to support Emily. I've been watching her for years, like years. Seen her family grow and everything, so seeing her succeed in this manner is something that I'm very proud of, and I'm very happy for her. So if you haven't already, please go ahead and check it out. See you again in the next video, and if you haven't already, please subscribe and hit the notification button so that you know when I update. Give me a like.